Let's discuss rational exponents. So from earlier, let's write that down. From earlier, well, we had an earlier video called Introduction to Rational Exponents. And there we discovered that a to the 1 over n is the same thing as the nth root of a. That is the denominator here, the n, became the index of the radical. So that was great. And now what we'd like to do is extend the situation. So before we only had a 1 in the numerator. What happens though if you have something like this? So what about something like x to the 2/3? What should we make of that? What should we do with the, what's the meaning of the 2 and the 3? Well, consider this. If you have x to the 2/3, we know that's equal to x squared raised to the 1/3. Now, how do I know that? Well, we said earlier that when you have exponents, when you have an exponential expression raised to a power, you can multiply the exponents. And isn't it true that 2, which is the same as 2 over 1, isn't 2 over 1 times 1 over 3, isn't that the same thing as 2/3? It is. Now, like this, think about what this is saying. It's saying take all of x squared and raise it to the 1/3. Well, anytime I take something and I raise it to the 1/3, I can use this property. Why? Because it's like having 1/3. The 3 will become the index. So here, taking x squared to the 1/3, that's the same thing as taking the 3rd root of x squared. Okay? Now, there's nothing wrong with that. In fact, this is a fine way of thinking about x to the 2/3. Now, it turns out there's another way of thinking about it as well. Why? Well, we know that multiplication is commutative. In other words, you can think of the x to the 2/3. Isn't that the same thing as x to the 1/3 raised to the 2nd? After all, isn't 1/3 times 2 the same thing as 2 times 1/3? The fact that multiplication is commutative means that I can write x to the 1/3 squared, because I multiply 1/3 and 2 to get 2/3, and I can also write x squared to the 1/3. All I've done is I've reordered the 2 and the 1/3. So 2 here, 1/3 there, and now 1/3 and 2 there. In both situations, you're multiplying the exponents. But that gives us a slightly different interpretation. Why? Because what this is saying now is take x and raise it to the 1/3 and then square that. Well, first of all, what is x to the 1/3? Well, from our definition above, up here, x to the 1/3, that 3 becomes an index. So that would be this. X to the 1/3 is the same thing as the cube root of x, and then take that whole thing and square it. Do you see the difference between these two expressions? Here, the first one, I've taken x and I've squared it, and then I took the 3rd root of that. Here in the bottom one, I first took the 3rd root and then I squared. So I've basically reordered the operations. So this one, I took a root first and then I squared, and this one I first squared and then took a root. Now it turns out you can use either of these, okay? So we're going to introduce our definition for rational exponents now. And you can use whichever one you want, and we'll see that one of these actually has a slight advantage over the other in most situations. So here's a definition. So definition. Okay, when we write a to the m over n, it's good news, you have options. You can first use the denominator as an index of a radical, and you can first write this, the nth root of a, and then you can raise it all to the mth power. That's one option. Or, so you can do this, here's your second choice. Or you can first choose to take a and raise it to the power m, and then you take the nth root. Okay, so once again, the difference between the two is as follows. Do you want to first take a root? Do you first want to make use of the n in the denominator and then the m afterwards? Or would you first like to take a and raise it to the nth, that is the numerator, and then take the nth root? The choice is yours. Let's go ahead and see an example of how to make use of this. Okay. Let's say you wanted to simplify. And you had, how about 8 raised to the 2 over 3? And so once again, I see I have two things going on, right? I have a numerator, and that's going to be a power, and I have a denominator, and that's going to be an index. So what I first choose to do, and this is just a choice I'm making right now, I'm going to first deal with the denominator, and that means use the 3 as an index. So I first take the third root of 8. And then after that, don't forget, you still have to make use of the numerator, and then you would square. And when I do that, what do I get? Well, the cube root of 8, as we know, is equal to 2, but don't forget, you still have to square it, and when you do that, you get 4. So that would be my answer. 8 raised to the 2/3 is equal to 4. Now, you may want to do this another way. You might say, and this is fine, this is equivalent. You could say, I want to take that 8 to the 2/3, and I don't want to deal with the denominator first, I want to deal with that numerator. Well, that means you're going to take 8 and square it first, and then after that, you're going to take the cube root. So you've just interchanged the order of the operations, which is fine. So in this case, I'd have, let's see, well, 8 squared is 64, so you'd have the cube root of 64, and let's see, the cube root of 64 is 4. Notice how you got the same answer, and that's because of our definition. You can do it either way and you'll get the right answer. Now, which way was better? I think this first way was better, and the reason is because if I look at this, I only had to take the cube root of 8. So 8's pretty small, and that was easy, right? The cube root of 8 was 2. But look what we had to do down here. Because we first squared 8, that gave us 64. And the cube root of 64 isn't terribly hard, but we had to think a little more, right? Because 64 was a larger number. So generally speaking, what we often do with rational exponents is we often take care of the denominator first. We often take the cube root. We often use the denominator as the index. That is, we first take care of roots, and then we take care of powers. Now, in this case, it wasn't a big deal, but consider this next situation. This might motivate things a little bit more. So let's say that you wanted to simplify. How about we had something kind of large, like 27 to the 2/3? Okay? Well, same logic, right? That is, why don't we first deal with the denominator? So it's the cube root of 27, and then after that, you've got a square, right? And do you remember what the cube root of 27 is? It's 3. And 3 squared is equal to 9. So 27 to the 2/3, I get 9. Now, if you choose to do it the other way, so if you first take that 27 to the 2/3 and you say, oh, I'm not going to deal with the denominator first, I want to first deal with that numerator. Well, then you're going to have to take 27 and square it. So you're going to take 27, you're going to square that, and then you're going to take the cube root of that. Well, that's a pretty large number. 27 squared, what's that equal to? Well, 27 times 27, we could figure that out, but that's going to take a little time, and then we're going to have to take the cube root of that. Again, that's going to be a little time consuming. Now, it turns out you'll still get 9. You'll get the same answer, but going from here to here was a little bit hard. And that's why we often prefer to take the root first so that we can deal with smaller numbers. Okay, so there's one more situation we want to talk about with rational exponents. So recall, a rational exponent is just an exponent that's a fraction. Now, in this case, you have a positive fraction, right? 27 to the 2/3. But you might be wondering, is it possible to have a negative exponent? And the answer is, of course. So recall from the previous video involving negative exponents, recall that when you have 2 to the negative 3rd, that's the same thing as 1 over 2 to the 3rd. So you can always take a negative exponent, and the exponent becomes positive if you put the whole thing in the denominator. Okay? So consider that in this next example. So let's say that you wanted to simplify. Okay, let's say that you had 16 raised, and here's your exponent, to the negative 3/2. Okay, so when I look at this, the first thing I think is this. I have three things going on. I have a negative, I have a numerator of 3, and I have a denominator of 2. Now here's the key to this problem. Each of these, the negative, the 3, and the 2, they all correspond to separate operations. The negative means I'm going to make use of the reciprocal like over here. The 2 in the denominator means I'm going to be dealing with a radical, and a 3 means I'm going to be dealing with a power. So I'm going to handle each of those in order. Well, not in order, but in a way that I think makes things easy. So I'm going to first deal with the negative. That means I'm going to write the whole thing as 1 over 16 to the 3 over 2. Okay. Now you don't have to do it this way, but I think it makes our life a little easier. Do you see how the negative exponent became a positive, and the negative is gone? So I've taken care of one of the three operations. Now in the denominator, I have to deal with the 2 and I have to deal with the 3. But that's easy. We know how to deal with the 2, right? The 2 just corresponds to the square root. So don't forget, it's still 1 over, well, it's going to be the square root of 16, and the 3 corresponds to taking a power. So it's the square root of 16 raised to the 3rd power. So then when I evaluate that, what do I get? 1 over, well, the square root of 16 is 4, and I still have to take that 4 and cube it, and then when I do that, I get 1 over 64, and that's my final answer. So remember, whenever you're dealing with an exponential expression, and you have an exponent that's a negative fraction, there are really three things to take care of. The negative means you want to take it as 1 over that, so that the exponent becomes positive. And then the denominator corresponds to taking a root, and the 3 corresponds to taking a power. So that's how you handle rational exponents. And in the next video, what we'll do is we'll deal with simplifying more complicated rational expressions involving rational exponents.